Welcome back to Breslov Campus. Some insights into the Parsha of the week, Parshat Shemot, Exodus, the new book. Rebbe Nachman has a beautiful insight hidden in the opening verse of this week's Parsha. He says, if you look at the last word, letters of the words of the first verse, Ve'ele, that's a hey at the end, Shmot, Tav, Bnei Yisrael, that's a Yud and a Lamed, Habaim, Mem, Mitzrayma, Hey, Et, Yaakov, it's Tav and Bet, Ish Ubeito, Shin, and Vav, Ba'u. Right? Ba'u is not included. If you take the last letters of these words, they spell out two new words here. Tehillim and Tshuva. And Rabbi Nachman reveals that if someone really, really wants to do Tshuva, he should say Tehillim, say Psalms. Because the power of Psalms is that they can open all the gates, all the doors in front of a person and bring him to the right address. To explain, in Judaism, everything is measured in numbers related up to the number 50. For example, we're taught there's 50 gates of holiness, there's 50 gates of repentance, there's 50 gates of purity, and the opposite, there's 50 gates of impurity. Like we said, for example, we're taught that the Jews in Egypt, they reached the 49th level of impurity. And if they were to wait a bit more, they would have sunken into the level of 50th gate level of impurity and never have left Egypt. So we know these concepts. We heard them in the teachings of the rabbis, of the Gemara, Rashi, etc. So the number 50 is considered the maximum. And Tehillim, Rabbi Nachman reveals, has the power to open each and every single one of these gates, of these 49 gates, and bringing a person to the 50th gate. Because a person is rooted in one of these 49 gates. So what's this idea of being rooted in the 49 gates? Rabbi Nachman says, look at the next verse in this week's parsha. Because we said, Ve'ele shmot bnei Yisrael ha'ba'im mitzrayma et Yaakov ish ubeito ba'u. These are the names of the sons of Israel who came down to Egypt, Yaakov and his sons, each one in his family came down. And then the next verse begins to list the 12 sons, excluding Yosef, who was already in Egypt, so it's 11 sons. But with Yosef, you'll see if you add up the letters of their names, like Reuven, Resh, Aleph, Vav, Bet, Nun, you go on Shimon, Shin, Mem, Ayin, Vav, Nun, etc. Add up the letters to the names, including Yosef, you come to 49. So Rabbi Nachman, bringing based on the teachings of the Kabbalah, the AriZal, that each Jew in this world, his soul root is rooted in one of the letters of one of the 12 tribes. Even though you may physically be a Kohen or a Levi or Yisrael, but your soul root, which also, by the way, as the Zohar explains a lot, your characteristics and definition of how you are show, for those people who know how to determine it, by the way, from what tribe you're rooted. You have some people, for example, who are warriors and ready to face any difficult situation. They're like rooted in the tribe of Dan, for example. The Dan was someone who went out to war and battled. He was able to fight. You have someone who's Yehuda, who has kingship, rulership. Levi, which is holiness, Kedusha, etc. People and their attitudes can indicate on a certain level what type of tribe they're rooted in. There's their characteristics, everything. People who have eyes, tzaddikim, they can see this. But the Jewish people, each person is rooted in one of the letters of one of the tribes. So someone who's from Levi will be rooted in the letter Vav, or letter Yud, or Lamed. And it's not just one person. It could be another few million Jews in the world who don't even know each other. They're rooted in the Vav of Shimon, or the Nun of Shimon, etc. Fine. So when a person wants to do tshuva, it's a few things. It's number one, he doesn't know which is his proper gate, which is his letter root in order to begin with. And like Rabbi Nachman says, that even if a person does find eventually where his place is, he'll find that the door is closed. It's locked. They're not letting him in because of his misdeeds. So what's needed is, number one, a power to help me find the right gate, my right address in life, who I really am, and to become accustomed to who I am, and to begin to working to serve Hashem from where I really am. Because you can have a person who's living an imaginary existence, and he thinks, yeah, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, and all these accomplishments, but it's all up in the air because the person is not starting from where and who he really is. So it's very difficult to help that person because he's not at where he is. He needs to be first at the right starting point. Be who you really are. You don't know who you really are, so it's a problem. We have to see what to help. And energy is needed to find me who I really am, bring me to the right address. Number two, if I do get to the right address, the doors are closed. They're not letting me in. Things are not happening. Hashem is preventing me from advancing. I'm getting an idea, a modukim of an idea of who I really am, but the doors are closed. So Rebbe Nachman teaches from these verses that we see in this week's parsha that the last letters of the first verse spell out Tehillim, Tshuva. He uses it as a point to prove that the power of Tehillim, reciting Tehillim, but what type of recitation? Not just to read the words like ignoramus, but to read the words with a feeling and a viewpoint of interpreting the verses on myself. Not just like King David expressing his personal battles and salvations and praises, but to take everything mentioned in the Psalms and interpret it on myself. With that point of view, Rabbi Nachman teaches that Tehillim can, number one, bring you to the right address, and number two, open the door if it's closed. This is the power of reciting Psalms hinted to in this week's parsha, Shemot. We should be zoche, since anyways, Shemot starts the period of 6 weeks called Shovavim. Shovavim is a word, an acronym, spelling out the first letters of the upcoming six parshas, starting with Shemot. You have Shemot, Va'era, Bo, Beshalach, Yitro, Mishpatim. It's called Shovavim. And the AriZal explains in the Kabbalah that this is a very propitious time to doing tshuva. It's a very special time to working on tshuva because we're reliving the Jewish exile in Egypt and getting out. By us reading the parshas now again of the enslavement of the Jews, the slavery, the difficulty, and the coming out and leading to the building of the Mishkan and the receiving of the Torah, so we're reliving that also. And for that we need the tshuva. And for tshuva, like we just mentioned now, we need Tehillim. We should be zoche, we should have the merit to be very careful to saying Tehillim, but to have a session of Tehillim where I'm reading the words carefully. I can have Tehillim where I'm reading the words fast, which is also special, it's also good. We're not going to deny that. The majority of people say Tehillim, unfortunately, because they're so under time constraints and so busy and their mind is not settled. So many people just say Tehillim fast. It's also accredited to something. But to get to what we're speaking about now in this class, to do Tehillim, to help me to do tshuva, I need to say it carefully, word for word, and to find myself in the words of Tehillim.